Let us move on to plastics. Students, plastics are available in different shapes, sizes, colors, and different materials. Did you all know that even the plastics are made up of polymers? This is a very interesting chapter. Let us see what are these plastics made up of. So the plastics is also a polymer like your synthetic fibers. Even they have the small units. For example, polythene. This word has two words which are combined together. Poly means many and ethene. Ethene is a chemical again. So when all the ethenes combine, you get polythene. And hence you get the polythene bags. So this is a plastic which is made up of polythene and hence the name polythene bags. Now students, how are these polymers arranged in these plastics? Are they arranged in the same way? No. They have a peculiar manners to be arranged. So the units in the plastics are arranged in two ways. One is the linear polymer and the other one is the cross-linked polymer. Let us see what is the linear polymer. Here you can observe students, here the each unit is attached one after the other in a straight line and hence the name linear polymer. Now coming to the other one, here is the cross-linked polymer. Here you can observe that between the polymer there is a cross-linkage. So hence the name cross-linked polymer. So these are the two types of arrangements which is seen in the plastics. Coming to the properties of plastics. Students, there are some plastics which are able to bend easily. And there are some plastics which can be broken easily. And there are some plastics when you pour hot water into it, it will try to change its shape. You might have experienced this in your home. When you pour hot water in the plastic bottle, it will try to change its shape completely. It will undergo deformation. So depending upon the properties of the plastics, they are of two types. One is thermoplastics and the other one is the thermosetting plastics. Now let us quickly see what are thermoplastics. Students, thermo means heat. Okay, now when you supply heat to these type of plastics, they will try to deform, they will try to melt and it can be easily bent. And once it is melting, you can mold it again into different shape. Clear? So these are the thermoplastics. For example, here you can see there are some trays. These are some trays. Now, if it is broken, you can give it to the recycling unit. So what they do, they will try to supply heat to it, melt it, and again it can be molded into different shape for different purposes. So all the thermoplastics are recyclable. They are recycled, okay? Moving on to the next is thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics are the plastics which when once molded, after that, how much ever heat is supplied, it will not melt. It will not become soft. So they are very much hard. How much ever you supply the heat, they are not going to change itself. So those are the thermosetting plastics. You might have seen the handles of the pan and the cooker in the kitchen, which is made up of thermosetting plastics. And also, These wires, they have the insulators on top of it, the coating on it. So they are also thermosetting plastics, which will not melt on heating. And these thermosetting plastics cannot be recycled. They cannot be recycled. So these are the two types of plastics, that is thermoplastic and the thermosetting plastics. Let us quickly learn some of the values which we learned in today's class. Students, the polyesters and acrylic fabrics are unique in their own properties. And hence, even you are unique. Even you have your own individual talents which you have to find out and enhance it. Also, be flexible like the thermoplastics. Okay. The way the thermoplastics are flexible in nature, it can be remolded. Even you have to accept all the positive changes around you. And the thermosetting plastics are highly determined type. They are not changing how much ever heat you supply. Similar to that, even you shouldn't get distracted. You have to be determined to achieve your own aim. Clear? Okay, student, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the class. Have a good day. Thank you.